Hello and welcome to all. In this video, we will learn about goods receipt in SAP. But before we start, if you are not yet subscribed to our My Support Solutions YouTube channel, then click on the subscribe button. Also, don't forget to click on the bell icon so that you will get the latest updates after every new video upload. This is totally free. Please like and share this video, share the knowledge, sharing is caring. Now, let us start. So in this video, we will learn about goods receipt in SAP. Let us first understand what is goods receipt is. We'll take an example. Our company has raised a purchase order. This is our purchase order number 17231. On the name of a vendor, let's say our vendor is ABC. Now, we have raised this purchase order for our material 100-100 and quantity is 10 pieces. Now, what vendor will do is, our vendor will dispatch these 10 pieces of this product to our plant. Our plant is 1000, which we have mentioned in our purchase order. Okay, now when we receive that 10 pieces in our plant or in our warehouse, our plant persons will check the quality and quantity of the product. And after checking, they will create a GRN, that is goods receipt. Okay, so goods receipt, we can say, is a confirmation that whatever material we have mentioned in the purchase order that we have received in our respective plant, then we have to pay to that vendor. After GRN or goods receipt, system will create two documents. One is material document and second is accounting document. Okay, now we will do practicals. We will use a transaction code MIGO to take a goods receipt. This is our purchase order number 17231. In this example, I will show you how to take a goods receipt against purchase order. Here I will put the respective purchase order number. In our example, our purchase order number is 17231. 45000 17231. Okay, now see, when we select goods receipt against purchase order, our movement type is 101. What is movement type? I have created a separate video on movement types, so you can refer that video to get a good knowledge or idea about this movement type. Right now I have select goods receipt against purchase order and I have mentioned our purchase order number. I will press enter. Now system will show the contents of this purchase order. We have created 10 pieces of the material 100-100. Okay, so system will show you the contents of the purchase order. Now see, delivery note. So in this column of delivery note, we can enter the vendor's delivery challan or note. Okay, then bill of lading. In this column, if we are purchasing the material from foreign, that is our vendor is import vendor, then we have to enter the bill of lading document number. In case of a domestic vendor, we can enter our LR, that is lorry receipt number or docket number, into this field. Okay, now see, this GR/GI slip number, this field is useful in the particular countries only, and we have to enter this field as per the country's law. Okay, now see, in material tab, system will show the details of the material. Now in quantity tab, okay, here we have to mention the quantity received. In the purchase order, we have mentioned 10 quantity, and here we can change this quantity also. Suppose we received a 9 quantity, then we can change this to 9. Right now I will take the full quantity, that is full GRN. Now see, in where tab, here we can mention our storage location. Storage location is a physical place where we store the material in our plant. Okay, so here we have to mention our storage location. If we have not mentioned storage location in the purchase order, If you have mentioned the storage location in the PO itself, then there is no need to enter here again. Now, goods recipient, the name of the goods recipient. Here we can mention the name of the person who unload the material. Okay, so the goods recipient or who enter the GRN into our system. It is based on the process in the company. Now, stock type. This is unrestricted use by default. That is OK stock, or we can sell this stock. Okay, here we can select quality inspection or block stock also as per our requirement. Now, in purchase order data, delivery completed indicator is one that is set automatically. If we change this to second, that is set, what will happen? See, if we select this second field, okay, no storage location, I will change the storage location, okay, 0001. Okay, see, if we change this field to set, that is second, what will happen? See, if we change the quantity from 10 to 9, let's say, then system will treat this purchase order as a completed. That is, system will not expect further GRN. Okay, in normal situation, what will happen? See, suppose we take any short GRN, that is, in our purchase order, we have mentioned 10 quantity, okay, and at the time of taking a GRN, we are taking the 9 quantity. So, one quantity is, the PO is open for one quantity, okay, but if we select this delivery completed indicator as a second set, then system will not expect the further GRN. Okay, this is the use of this field. So, I will click on the check button. Before this check, we have to click on the item OK flag. Okay, just a bit. Here we click on item OK flag. Now, I will click on the check button. Okay, see, system has given this information message or warning message that deficit of order quantity 1 piece, because in our purchase order we have mentioned 10 pieces, but we are taking goods receipt only for 9 pieces, that is 1 piece short receipt. So system has informing, or system has show us the warning message. Now the item will be flagged as delivery completed. Why? Because in our purchase order data, we have choose the second option, that is set option. Earlier I have told you that. See, this is second option. Because of this, system has shown this warning message. The item will be flagged delivery completed. Now we will post the document. After post the document, system will create a two different documents, that is, one is material document and second is accounting document, and our stock will also get updated. We will click on the post button. So system will post the document, and then system will generate accounting document and material document both after posting of the document. Okay, so see, material document has been posted. That's all for now in this video, and if you have any queries or suggestions regarding this video, please feel free to comment. Thanks for watching, keep in touch, and bye bye.